Frosty relationship between Sino Hydro and government agency UEGCL reached a boiling point when they clashed before Energy and Mineral Development Minister Ruth Nakaria last year. UEGCL accused the former team of doing shoddy works.
But we also are grateful for the support we received from the Mine Ministry, the Minister of Energy. They've coordinated high-level meetings which involved the Chinese ambassador in Uganda. They involved the company in China at a very high level. So the person we've got, you have no doubt that is the best they would give us.
One of the key staff that they have brought in is the quality manager. So if you see the challenges that we have been that have delayed these works, they are all quality related. It was the quality of construction, the quality of workmanship. So they have brought in a new quality manager, and that's the
commissioning of the 600 megawatt Karuma hydropower project was initially scheduled for December 2018, which was not met.
And we are optimistic that even the remaining few works that they need to complete so that the plant can be ready for commissioning, they have promised us, they are discussing, they are engaging, and they are going to come up with an implementation plan for commissioning the plant. So they are going to come with a fully resourced commissioning plan, indicating what needs to be done, when will it be done, and the commissioning is going to happen in phases, so all that will be reflected on the schedule.
Of course, we are confident we will do our effort, big effort, to complete it as a mini job as soon as possible. We see today we have got very good workmanship.
Key among the concerns were the poor workmanship that Sino Hydro had done, especially on electromechanical installations.
Before we had a small cabinet and then cables of the wrong specification. For instance, the cross-section area was larger than allowed for, and then this was very congested. You'd hardly have any room to even put your arm. And the thinking was, if you go to a time where you have to carry out operation and maintenance, O&M work, how do you access the cabinet? How do you identify what is wrong? And how do you eventually do the time? Did the interventions, brought larger cabinets, brought cables of the right specification, and then did the cable pulling with new cables through new cable routes, and did proper termination work. As you can see, the cabinet is neat. The earthing wires, the cables from the machines are all terminated properly. We have touch protection. We have the ducting in place.
EGCL says it's impressed with the rectification works that have so far been done by the contractor. A set of new cables have also been installed at the project. Karuma is developed at a cost of $1.7 billion, and upon completion, it shall add up to 600 megawatts to the country's already installed generation of 1,260 megawatts. Story by Ben Ojambo for the news.